stream series. We're working on an open source web application called Jerry Life. It's a well-being instrument to promote active lifestyles in elder care communities. Today we're working on a feature that allows us to assign users to groups, and these groups are essentially used to organize our data model. Basically, we have homes. Let me just go to the front page real quick. We have sort of residents who live in homes and do activities with various facilitators like staff and family volunteers. And so the residents are grouped into homes, and homes are grouped into groups. And what we're going to do is add staff to these home groups. And that means that the staff would only have visibility and access to the home groups where they're assigned. Because as our system is growing, you might have dozens of homes, and a staff person might only work at one or two or one group. So this is our sort of design goal here. I've got a working work in progress modal dialog here. When you go to the users page, you can edit the groups. I've got some boilerplate groups listing here. What I'm working on now, I just fixed a small bug. Thought I was live streaming, but it was recording to my drive. But anyway, I haven't been working too much, so I'm just gonna continue. So let me just commit this change. That bug was so small it didn't really warrant its own issue. But in the meantime, what I'm trying to do here is get actual groups into the user interface, into the client from the server. So the approach I took is kind of a common Meteor paradigm. It's based on reactive subscriptions. So essentially, we have Mongo collections on the server, and anytime one of those collection changes, it can send out the modified documents to any client that has subscribed or where that has an active subscription relating to the changed documents. So it's not replicating the whole database, it's just the parts that changed that are relating to what you're subscribing, the data you're subscribing to. I'm not sure how long for the world that the Meteor project in general is, but also that reactive subscription thing, I think some of the Meteor community kind of picked it apart, and from what I understand, you're supposed to use methods now to retrieve data in the client. I don't know how reactive methods are. But anyway, I'm going to go with the subscription approach. So I've got an all group subscription that's now sending all the groups to the client. So when the edit user groups modal is created, it's going to subscribe. And I was just counting the groups and logging that. Came back to zero. so it should be 3. Okay, I see these are sequential. Yeah, we got 3 groups here. All right. Each group's got 2 keys, as you can see, a name and the group ID. So we're just going to populate this list with that data. All right, so to do that, we're going to hop over to we're going to create a helper, I believe. This is our editor template. Consists of just like a form, just a regular HTML form. I noticed that my stream is kind of flickering, the video is flickering a little bit. I'm turning redshift off to see if that helps. Not only maybe improve the visibility of the stream, but get rid of that flicker. I think that's the cause. Not sure what else it would be. Okay. All right, I see I've got 1 active viewer. Hey, how you doing? Welcome to the room. Go ahead and feel free to send me a chat, or if you got any questions about the project or any comments on the coding style or the goals here, I'd be interested to read your perspective. Okay, so basically we're gonna create a template helper now. We got these subscription ready, and a template, edit user groups, helpers. Takes an object and we'll call that groups. It's going to find all groups and return them. And I'm a little bit rusty here, but essentially we're going to now iterate over those. To look this up, blaze 4, I think blaze uses hash. I think it's like that. I might have to look in the docs. It's been a while. I'm sort of switching over to use Vue.js lately. It's very similar to Blaze. Templates. I don't remember this stuff very well. Find data view instance helper parent body. Bin maps. Space bars. 4. Where's 4? Each. Let's do that. Okay, so yeah, double. For grouping groups. Now I see the stream still flickering, so I don't know, there's something wrong with my video card. I apologize for that. I don't know what to do about it. I have proprietary drivers installed, you know, just something about the compositing in Ubuntu. So in our select, we've got a, we're iterating over the groups. What I want to do is I want to check the template subscription ready. So I'm looking at the Blaze docs and it just doesn't have a search function that I can see, gosh. Yeah, I just want to see that the subscription's ready. I understand what this is doing, so let me just let's console log this. There we are. All right, so there was just my closing tag was wrong. Wasn't really giving me a meaningful error in the console here. Or maybe it was and I just didn't understand. All right. Perfect. All right, starting there, let's commit this. A little bit of work, a little bit of improvement there. it's landing, so there's a lot of green here, but more or less it's only a few changes. Right, now I need an event handler. So essentially, when somebody submits this form, it needs to do something. Clicking cancel is just going to dismiss. But when I click save, what does it do? Refreshes the page. Because it's in a form, it doesn't technically need to be in a form. So let me think of that. It was important for accessibility or something that it'd be in a form. I don't know off the top of my head if that form tag is necessary. I can prevent the default. This is one of the good things about AutoForm is it kind of handles these little nuances for me, and I can do a method form. I'm going to take the form off the page, form markup. And I'll add an event listener. An event map. So I'm going to say listen for the click event. This is one thing I kind of like the way view does this a little bit better. You put your events right there on the DOM item, DOM element. Let's see. So what button? Submit here. Save. I'm using camel case here in the attribute because it's tied to a JavaScript, so it's like a little convention I've adopted. All right, so let's take a look at it, how it's gonna work. And there it goes, so got the event. Now, if it were a form, though, I would do. Actually, let me double check this. Well, in any case, I better grab the selected groups. Alright, so basically that's it. And we're going to grab the group IDs from this DOM element, the selected ones. We're going to call a method that's going to create, you know, zero or more documents. I suppose you could submit this without anything. Which would basically be the equivalent of cancel. In which case, it wouldn't have to do anything. Well, anyway, all right, so let's go for it. First, we're going to grab this DOM element. So the template instance is passed in as the second argument to the event. Let me just console log this first. Well, I think there's a dollar. jQuery is attached here. See if that works. And right, it's going to return an array. See, there's a native method for slim select. Oh yeah, good. Give it a, we'll assign it to the template instance so I can reference it later. And then I don't have to do, I already have it right here. Right, so. And then I can get from the slim select API, there's a selected method. Notice that this jittering screen is only on the side of the Visual Studio code. It's not doing it in the browser window. I'm wondering if that, it's kind of strange. Or what's going on? There's something, some syntax error. No. Brings up the menu, selects a couple of them, saves it. Yeah, there we go. If I remove this selection, boom, nice. I'll figure out what, if anything, to do in the case of a no selection. Maybe it's not a big deal to just close the dialog. But okay, cool. Now we got an array of group IDs. Yeah, there we go. Now we're gonna make a server method. And we'll need a collection for this. Because I think this will be queried both from the group, but also from the user. So if we just have its own collection, and each document in that collection just corresponds to a one-to-one, and then I could index the fields. Yeah, I think that's the way to go. So what should we call this? Call it permissions. And we can later add another attribute, like an array of permission types or something like that. So we can have different roles, different user roles assigned to these. So I'm just going to do some copy paste. I need to right off the bat do this event logging, though we do have this audit log. Just checking, I'm using plural everywhere. I just think if that were one thing I would change about these is they would be singular, but in your case. I'm gonna stick with that. I will add indexing to these columns. I believe we'll want to look them up fast. Essentially, they're foreign keys from my perspective, and foreign keys are typically indexed for quick traversal. Great. Let's see, schema. We should add the event logging. For auditing purposes, permissions on the permissions. So this just logs events across our data model. We want to know who did what to what type of entity, and specifically which entity. All right. And the last part is permissions. This is not the recommended way to do permissions in Meteor.js. So don't follow this approach. I guess these allow deny rules have been proven to be ineffective or something. But I haven't gotten to the point of, or to the, yeah, basically gotten around to refactoring to the correct way, which are called validated methods. Which, to my understanding, just gets away from Meteor's core sort of ethos of like reactive data end-to-end reactivity. All right. So there's our event logging. Here's our allow deny rules. And I believe it, all of them should mandate the current user be admin. So let me just copy the body of this function to the insert rule. So basically we get the ID of the current session, check that they're an admin role, is we're in a new file. These should be const. Let const is the basically new way of declaring variables in JavaScript. And default should be const, unless you know that assignment is going to change. And so don't use var anymore. It's the running advice. Okay. So cool. I think this is pretty good. Now we need a method. Alright, so let me get the code. I first have to define this permission. So add user permissions. So this is a server method. We have a new collection. Meteor methods picks a map. I don't know why this is defaulting to 4. It's little things like that are a bit annoying. Okay. What is return true for the minute? This is really bad, this jittering in the feed. I'm really sorry about that. I tried changing my graphics driver and I don't know what to do. But it's just in VS Code. Looks like there's a bug report for it. Screen tearing and random glitching with window capture. So I could turn off VSync. Yeah, I could try that real quick. Settings. Settings advanced. VSync. I don't see a vsync setting. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is a similar issue. Otherwise, I can try it without window capture. The problem is I'm just having trouble showing both the browser and the IDE at the same time, particularly since my IDE is changing. Aspect ratio. Well, I'll try to fix this later. Most of the people reporting troubles with the browser rendering, I'm having troubles with my VS Code. Causes my screen flicker when running 4K. Dang it. External monitor. Alright. Alright. So, there's not an error. We want to hide this modal, so let me just go ahead and grab the snippet to close the modal dialog, which I believe was on the actions.js modal show, so it'll be modal hide, this one. Let's see if this is working. I don't see any errors in the browser console. Yeah. Let's see if this is the problem. I believe there might always be an error. Maybe? No, it shouldn't be. Yeah, anyway. I need to pass two things. So I need group ID. Let me think, what am I doing here? This is tricky. I'm getting a little bit tired too. The context here is that we're on the user, we have a selected groups. Add single user permissions. I recall correctly, we're passing the user ID as an instance variable. User dot underscore ID. All right, so we have the user and ID there. Passes this function, so user ID selected groups. Selected group IDs, or just group IDs is fine. This is an affirmative case. You know, these are global. I didn't export it. No, I just had dot. Jesus, why did I do that? And this will unpack it. We're using the same variable names as the fields, so we can use destructuring here. So since the group IDs, we're looking at each of them, I'm gonna add a new permission. So for this new user, and what do I got a syntax error? No. Come on. There it goes. Now down here we should see some console logging. Here we go, can I write property ID of undefined? Alright. Okay, yeah. Yep. It's in the data property. Man. And then I want to give it. Actually, just call it user because that's what it is. I believe this should work. And up here, I can probably clean these up and say user is user. I'm getting tired, so making really simple mistakes. That, and now we have a little bit of exceptions for each of undefined. So we got an array that's defined and a single user ID. This should now be an empty array and a single user ID. Good. So those seem to be defined. Single user permission, user ID, group IDs. Watching down here, we got user ID, group IDs. It's looking good. So group IDs is not undefined. Oh. What the hell did happen there? That was weird. Oh, I see what happened. I didn't replace the array part. I prefixed it with group IDs. Okay, a little bit better. Let's see, resin ID is required. Damn. There we go. Great, some small gotchas. Let's go ahead and commit these changes, and I'll do one more thing before calling this good. When I open this now, I should have some groups pre-selected because they're now should be some permissions saved. So user ID and group IDs. So this is what we saw logged here. Cool. Let me clean up these console logs real quick. Permissions, edit. Dang it. Now the other part will be to query the existing user permissions in this edit form and pass them in to this lim select so that it will be pre-selected from the list. Oh man, this is challenging. They'll also need to be able to delete the ones if. I think I'm gonna have to sleep on this. I just realized that I'm gonna get in some really complicated territory with the since I chose the multiple document approach, I'll have to figure out how to keep the documents in sync with the user interface. In other words, if somebody removes some of these permissions, how do I know which ones were removed? Well, I mean, essentially it would be, this is the single source of truth, more or less, I mean, from this callback, I have everything I need to know right here, once I get this pre-populated. And even then, if I didn't have it pre-populated, I'm just in this server hook, delete all of the group permissions for that user, and add only the ones that existed. So I think I could work that way. It just sounds kind of dangerous, deleting all the permissions, but I don't think maybe it's not going to be that big of a deal. I don't know, let's find out. All right, first let's get this pre-populated. So when I open up this, we're going to get the current user permissions per groups. Keeping in mind, you know, we're editing multiple users here. So we'll get the user permissions for the user ID. Yeah, good. Now slim select should give me a way. First I have to check that the subscriptions are ready. Then run into slim select. It should give me a way to preemptively select some. Yeah, there's a set method. Nice. There may be even just an option for that, so I don't have to use the method. More, little, slightly more declarative. Select data. So we'll render this when they're ready. That gives us a chance to grab those and then select. Let me think here. we're going to get all the group, the existing user permissions, then grab the group IDs and call a method in the slim select called set. And we're going to set it to the value of existing. We need to get user ID. There we go. We're doing too many steps at once. Let's check each of these along the way. Well, it's got to be getting in here because it's rendering the slim select. I don't have this permission set up. I mean, this publication. There we go. Whew. All right, final stretch. I'm gonna, every time we submit this form, just delete all the user permissions that exist, because there should only, this should only ever, this is like the canonical list of user permissions that we'll be submitting in the form. So delete them all and then add the ones here. I think that's a relatively safe thing to do. Can't think of another way that's about that simple of achieving this. So let me get these committed. on that server method. Four permissions. Can't be quite so simple yet. No. Server method permissions. And if it's more than zero, it'll add new ones. But if you pass it in a zero length array, it's going to remove those, remove everything. Yeah, it makes sense. Okay. Let's test it out. So I've got two there. I'm going to remove one. Save it. Got one there. Add two. Save it. I'm going to add all three of them and save it. Delete all. I think it's just working. Sometimes that doesn't render. Okay, yeah, that's the reactivity part. The template is rendering only, you know, only once. It's, it only gets called once. I'm checking for the subscriptions at render time. And they're not going to be ready yet. They're not going to be guaranteed to be ready when it renders. They could take time. So I need this actually to be reactive. The template needs to be rendered in order to render the slim select on top of this existing UI component. But I need to run this reactively. So that when this subscription is ready changes, this is a reactive data source that will trigger this function to rerun. And at that point, everything should kick off. We'll get it slim select. Checking these, you know, data that are now dependent on that, those template subscriptions, etc. Getting the user IDs and then pre-populating it. All right, let's see what happens. Consistently, so we're not everyone's more misfiring though. What is the data? Yeah, un LM puesto. It's really kind of non-deterministic here. What to do? I don't know what to do. It's almost like this isn't firing sometimes. Let me see if that's the case. Like this is increasingly rare. There it is. Let me try the other approach. If there's just a property here, I can pass the data in at render time. I don't know if it's gonna work. It's just on the dark. It's not in the docs. Doesn't work. Looks like Slim selects a view made with Vue.js. Yeah, and just from the docs, it doesn't seem like there's a property for setting the values. I think I just have to chalk this up to a known value, I mean a known bug. The code as I'm writing it seems correct. The API I'm using seems correct. There's no property or no option. Even their demos are buggy. Well, I don't know. Well, sort of. In any case, I'm going to call it Almost good, man. It's kind of bothersome. I'm wondering if I moved this earlier. It's just so non-deterministic. I'd almost chalk it up to a bug in Slim Select. In any case. I'm gonna keep this code pretty close. In the same block, more or less, because I should have everything I need here. These subscriptions should be ready. This stuff should be relatively quick. And this is where it's breaking down. I'll see if there's bugs that come in. Report that if anything, they'll just delete the user permissions by accident and have to re-add them. All right, okay. Stuff like that's kind of disappointing though. I mean, they're a little unsettling, I guess, to not have confidence that this is going to work. About that. You know, at some point I might be just replacing Slim Select or the whole front end with Vue.js, so I'm not sure if it's worth fighting this much more. We're getting further down the road right here with the work that we've gotten accomplished today, so that's good enough to call it a day. So thank you very much for watching. To the online viewers and YouTube, anybody watching this on YouTube, I appreciate any comments or feedback you'll provide, any suggestions or questions about the project or the methodology. All right, well, thanks again for watching and have a great day.